Dobro večer, dragi gledatelji. Večeras imam posebno zadovoljstvo najaviti gošću. Moja gošća Viktorija Zinčuk. Nadam se da sam izgovorio korektno ovaj akcent. Dobro večer, dobrodošli. Jesam li dobro rekao prezime Zinčuk?
Da.
Vi ste Ukrajinka, pa to je nama dosta blisko. Nadam se da evo, neću puno griješiti kada se oslovljavam. Moja gošća došla u Hrvatsku, ne iz Ukrajine, nego dug je to bio preko Pariza, Maroka i tako dalje. A ona je direktorica u Hrvatskoj Europske EBRD-a, dakle Europske banke za razvoj. Razgovarat ćemo naravno o svim tim temama koje podrazumijeva vaša pozicija, vaš status. I najbolje da počnemo, ja uvijek to kažem, ali da sam gledatelj nedosljedan po savjetu. Ne znam, ste vi djetetu čitali Alisu zemlju čudesa, imate moj savjet kako je najbolje početi. Od početka, pa krenimo tako. Šta je to EBRD?
Dobro večer. My name is Viktorija Zinčuk and I'm very happy to be here. And I did read Alice in Wonderland long time ago. So let's start from the beginning. So EBRD, European Bank for Reconstruction and Development, was established 30 years ago. This year we will be celebrating 30th anniversary of the bank, but also 25th anniversary of EBRD here in Croatia. The bank was established in order to help countries from post-communism region to transition into more market-oriented economies. At this point in time, we are owned by more than 69 countries, as well as EU and EIB. And we operate in more than 30 countries. This is much more than we initially planned to have within our operations. But now, as never before, we continue to be relevant.
Vi volite reći u vašoj banci da niste obična banka i da zapravo mijenjate način života ljudi. Na što točno mislite?
Yes, this is EBRD's logo, EBRD's motto, we invest in changing lives. And I think we don't actually repeat it often enough. What does it mean, investing in changing lives? For us, it means that we are doing business as any other bank. So we provide money to companies or the governments for the projects that we finance. But we also want to achieve a change. It's not enough for us just to provide financing. We want to make sure that the companies that we work with change the way they operate, that they invest in better technologies, that they invest in changes in the corporate governance, but also the governments. When we work with the governments, when we work with public sector clients, we're looking for some changes, for reforms. This is effectively what it means, changing lives.
Kad imam goste iz Hrvatske, oni su poznati našoj publici, no vama ćemo ovo dati priliku da se malo i predstavite. Rekao sam da ste došli iz Ukrajine gdje ste rođeni, živjeli ste u Parizu. Nakon toga, dugi niz godina, živjeli ste u Londonu, došli ste u Hrvatsku iz Maroka. Kako izgledate put i kad počinjete raditi za ovu banku?
So I started working at with EBRD actually more than 20 years ago. When I started my career as a young banker in Ukraine, I happened to work for a commercial bank that was working with EBRD. And I was hired to help that bank to start the first project, cooperation on an SME credit line. At the time, I was the only person who spoke English. And this was the reason why actually they hired me, and this is why they so that I was the right person to help EBRD to understand what that commercial bank was doing. Later on, I left Ukraine and I worked in a private sector in England, having spent 6 months in Paris. And a few years later, I realized that there was something in EBRD's mandate that was lacking while working in those private sector companies in London. So I decided that it was probably time to look back and go back to the roots effectively. So I came to EBRD, and it has been now 18 years since I'm with the bank, and I never regretted this decision. Coming to Croatia was probably an unexpected twist of life. I did work with Croatian companies back in 2003, 2004, 2005, and I would have never think that one day I will be living in this country. When I decided to opt for the job of a director in a country of operations, as we call it, I decided that it would be a good idea to first test the waters instead of plunging in and deciding that this is it for good. So I went to Morocco. This was a 6 months assignment. Mm-hmm. It was a test for me, I guess, a test for my capacity to lead the country, but also it was an interesting opportunity for me to see whether I would like to live in a different country and whether I would like to lead an office. And after Morocco, I realized that it was the job I love. This is the only job I want to do. And if I could manage a team of 24 Moroccan bankers in Morocco, I could do anything.
Nemojte biti sigurni, Hrvatska uvijek može iznenaditi. Recite mi, hoće li EBRD seliti iz Londona? Mnogi moji prijatelji, kad su čuli da ćete doći u emisiju, pitali su to pitanje, one tehničke naravi, ali zaista zanimljivo.
I assume you ask it because of Brexit.
Naravno.
Yes. So indeed, EU as well as EU countries represent more than 50% of the shareholding at EBRD. So this question, as you say, is logical. Would EBRD decide to move out from its London headquarters post-Brexit? Our management and our shareholders have discussed this at length, and the decision has been that no, we're not moving from London, we're staying.
Po čemu se vaša banka razlikuje od ostalih dosadnih, bezličnih međunarodnih institucija kako ih svi doživljavamo, ne samo u Hrvatskoj, nego širom Evrope? Vidim da se smijuljite, ali to je tako.
Well, first of all, I would say we do have a face and we have a presence. Woody Allen actually said at some point that 80% of success is showing up, is being present. So we are present here. We have an office here for the last 25 years. I have a team of 20 bankers who are present in Croatia. We have our office in Zagreb. And talking about us being boring, we're definitely not boring, because we can do various things here in Croatia. Not only we provide loans, as probably most of people think about. So we probably are more known for very large projects that we have done. But we also provide advisory. And we provide advisory to their government, to the associations, but also to SMEs, small companies. Mm-hmm. So when you go and do your shopping, you probably from time to time either do go to Veronica or at least you pass by Veronica shops here in Zagreb. So Veronica is one of our advisory clients. Some of you also know Aurelia, which is a pasta producer, Natura Vita.
Nećemo reklamirati nikoga.
Of course, but...
Dobro, hoćete reći, imate i malih klijenata, imate naprosto klijenata koji sa vama surađuju i koji koriste vaše usluge. Prije što razložimo svu tu vašu saradnju, recite mi, ipak nešto općenitije da uputimo gledatelje u to što EBRD jest. Je li njegova uloga danas ona koja je zamišljena 90-ih?
First of all, EBRD was initially created not to last forever. So people who initially created the bank were thinking that within 10 years, probably the mission of the bank or the role of the bank will be completed and maybe even this would be the end of the institution. So we were never created to be there for 30, 40, 50 years to come. But if you think about the relevance of the bank today, I would definitely say that even in its name, we can say how relevant we are, especially within this environment where we have COVID that has created totally unknown situation globally. And here in Croatia, if we speak very specifically, we also have the earthquake. So never as before, European Bank for Reconstruction and Development is relevant.
Recite mi, koje su bile vaše, pre nego što pitam što banka može učiniti za Hrvatsku, impresije o Hrvatskoj kad ste došli iz Maroka? Rekli ste da ste htjeli ispitati prvo malo vodu prije nego što skočite i zaplivate o njoj, pa ja uopće ne sumnjam sad već nakon ovih 15 minuta dobro vas poznavajući da ste učinili nekako ovo istraživanje, pripremili se za ovu sredinu i tako dalje, da vas je nečim iznenadila. Mislim na poslovno okruženje i bankovno ili evo najšire moguće poslovno okruženje.
One thing that surprised me here and continues to surprise me here is that for some reason you don't like celebrating successes. There is a lot said about things that don't work, but not enough said about the positive things, the opportunities, as well as those Croatian companies, individuals that make a difference.
And I think mogu li vas pitati, prošto vam upadam reći, to tako jest u Ukrajini, u Britaniji, u Francuskoj, u Maroku, da vole pobjednike, da vole uspješno u poslu, ne samo u sportu, nego tamo toleriraju uspjeh?
Tolerated is probably not the right word, because if you tolerate success, that's kind of an overstatement.
To najviše što mi Hrvati možemo. Znate, mi nismo izgradili nijedan slavoluk pobjede. Ovo je u Puli što imamo, to su Sergijevci napravili. Ne mi, Rimljani su zadnji koji su ovdje nešto tako činili.
Yes, no, definitely, okay, speaking about Ukraine, I left Ukraine more than 25 years ago. So I'm probably, I actually spent more from my adult life abroad than in Ukraine. And I would say that Ukrainian population is definitely not shy to speak about successes when the successes come along. In England, the culture is definitely very much focused on celebrating the successes, encouraging the successes, and encouraging young people to think outside of the box and be successful. So from that perspective, this is something that is definitely one thing that you can say about the cultures where I've lived.
To je sad vrlo zanimljivo zbog toga što bi mi Hrvati rekli da smo imali jedan zapravo socijalizam sa ljudskim licem, nije to bilo nikakvog egalitarizma, mi imamo ipak ovoga, tu kulturu individualizma, imamo uspješne pojedinačne sportaše koje slavimo, radimo im dočeke itd. Ali vidite, svatko ko dođe u Hrvatsku kaže mi upravo ovo što i vi, da ne volimo i ne slavimo uspjeh. Ne volimo izrazite, da ne volimo, ne potičemo tu kompeticiju i ne volimo pobjednike u njoj. Kako ste se vi odgovorili na to pitanje zašto je to tako?
I need to ask you this question. Why is this like this? It's difficult for me to say why, but I think it's just a matter of taking risks.
Aha.
You need to be able to take risks, you need to be able to speak your mind, and you need to be able to take the feedback. And sometimes feedback is not as pleasant as one would like, but not taking risks is not possible if you want to be successful.
Odličan odgovor, da. Mi očekujemo, čak se moja generacija šali i ovi mlađi imaju tu kovanicu, država doradi nešto. Dakle, to ponašaju ovaj socijalizma. Dakle, da nešto država učini za nas, a mi, eto, ovo je najvažnije. Ali to još, ja mislim, seže od Austro-Ugarske, jer naj naš mentalitet nije samo socijalizam kriv. No, idemo do ovog pitanja. Što EBRD može ponuditi Hrvatskoj? Govorili ste od suradnje sa vladom do malih, recimo, kompanijica, tvrtki. Ali, ajmo to strukturirati. Kakve projekte bi, recimo, čovjek trebao imati ili vlada, a da to vama bude zanimljivo?
Well, for us, it's not a question of selecting projects that will be interesting. For us, it's a question of having projects that will have an impact. So, as a result, this is really where we differentiate ourselves from probably other providers of capital. So, the projects whereby in the case of, for example, our long-standing relationship with HATS, the motorway company, we have contributed not just financially to the restructuring of this company, but also to creating what you know now as an infrastructure that everybody is using these days. Speaking about private sector companies, we would like to make sure that when they work with us, they bring the change that is necessary. Whether this is a family-owned company that is thinking about passing, where the owner is thinking about passing the company to the next generation and needs to think how to put in place the relevant corporate governance, whether these are financial institutions that are thinking how they could bring new products to the market. So last year, for example, and not naming clients, point taken, we have provided 100 million euro credit line for sustainable tourism. So not just tourism, but sustainable tourism. And that credit line comes with advisory services to the tourism companies. So these are the type of projects that we are very happy to finance. But at times, it's very hard to find this type of projects because not every client, whether it's public sector client or private sector client, wants to change the attitude, wants to make a difference, or wants to find new ways of doing business.
Ako se dobro sjećam, a vi me ispravite ako ja grešim, Elizabeta Campanelli, direktorica Svjetske banke za Hrvatsku, rekla da je Hrvatska, ima impresiju da je Hrvatska poput uspavane ljepotice. Htjelo se kazati, ja mislim da vi dijelite tu impresiju kad smo razgovarali, a samo smo kratko razgovarali 10 minuta prije emisije, da Hrvatska ima naprosto puno potencijala koja nikako na vaše čuđenje da realizira i aktivira. Zašto Hrvatska, najjednostavnije rečeno, ne koristi svoje potencijale?
You know, you ask me what were the things that have surprised me when I arrived here, and I was surprised how often people were talking about potential. The discussion about potential is ongoing and I think never ending. Sleeping Beauty, Croatia is definitely a beauty, and there is definitely a scope here for this land of opportunities to be even more beautiful than it is right now. Why? I think fundamentally it's again back to the same point that I have made before. It's you need to take risks. You need to make things happen. So for me, it's not a question of why things don't work, why potential is not being used. For me, the question is what are the projects, what are the deeds, what are the actions that we as individuals, we as a society, we as policymakers, we as lenders can put in place in order for this potential to come to fruition.
Dobro, ali kad komparirate recimo i sa okružjem i sa onim što znate i sa Zapada, pa eto i sa Maroka, iz Maroka, pardon, jesmo li mi, ne znam, onako mediteranski zapravo, čak i na kontinentu ovoga prepušteni mentalitetu manjana, lako ćemo, ko to more platiti, evo pogledajte, pa ko će raditi ovo ljeti? 3-4 mjeseca uz ovakvu obalu ne možete, nego u hladne, šta ćete sad raditi? Samo čekate, furešte i brojite. Tako da vidim da se smijete. Jesu li naše prirodne ljepote hendikep možda? Možda bi bilo lakše da smo u Švicarskoj. Ne znam kako da vam, evo reći ću vam to drugačije. Kakvi su hrvatski poduzetnici? Jel oni dovoljno znaju uopće da bi priredili nekakve projekte da bi se vam obratili?
I would say, again, we need to recognize that this is not just a country of a beautiful landscape and of a beautiful seaside. Of course it's beautiful. It's far more beautiful than many other countries, and you're spoiled for choice, that's for sure. And nobody will argue with this. Talking about companies, I think that we forget that this is a country that does have companies such as Infobip. It does have companies such as Remat. And we keep forgetting that Infobip was actually...
Te smijete spominjati, to su uzor, zbilje, to je sjajno, kao šapo tim kompanijama. We have the first unicorn, that Infobip.
Yes, and then not our client, so I'm not... Yes, but it's interesting to look, and as I say, these are not our clients, unfortunately, or not our clients yet. But I can speak about what I observe while looking at these type of companies. So Infobip was actually created as an initiative between a group of friends that were not necessarily thinking about it as a commercially viable enterprise. This was very much about digitalization of the community, and look where Infobip is now. And I think the country is, hopefully, and should be proud of having companies such as this one. There are also smaller companies, there are small associations that exist in this country, which do prove that despite this beautiful countryside, despite this beautiful sea, and despite the fact that, yes, maybe at times it's easier to take a break rather than focus on achievement of certain milestones, nevertheless, I do believe in Croatian companies, in Croatian people, and I think you do have what it takes. And you know, speaking about risk-taking and speaking about courage, it's not necessarily in line with your question, but I want to make this point still. I was amazed on the 29th of December last year, and in the weeks that follows, at the response of the Croatian people to what we have witnessed in Sisak and the neighboring areas. I don't know many countries in the world where people will do what Croatian people did. And it does require courage, it does require risk-taking, because when people were evacuating those who could not move from the hospitals, from their homes, they were taking risks, and Croatians were taking these risks, and they were united. People forgot about the holidays, people forgot about the New Year's Eve. They went, and there was such a unity, there was such an incredible response of the society, that I think this whole discussion about Croatia not being a risk-taking nation, being too conservative, I think when it takes, you do it.
To je veliki paradoks našeg mentaliteta i našeg svetonazora i našeg ponašanja, da sam ne igram sad prevelikog pučkog folklornog znanstvenika, ali mi jesmo zaista u ratu za poplave, za zemljopisa, za zemljotresa, pardon, složni, solidarni, pokazujemo sve najbolje odlike našeg karaktera, ljudskih karaktera uopće, a onda kad je mirno, onda nemate, kako ja to obično kažem, jednaku ogradu od Savudrije do Cavtata. Nećete naći zajedničku ogradu nigdje. Recite mi meni, što vi mislite da bi bilo bolje, drugačije, koje reforme Hrvatska mora učiniti?
I think this is another question which is very similar to the Croatian potential, which has been discussed so widely that if I were to start, I don't know if we will have enough time during this conversation to finish it. I will probably comment on two things. There is a Global Innovation Index, and there is doing business ranking, which is prepared every year, and where we can see where Croatia is. On doing business, Croatia is number 51. On the Global Innovation Index, Croatia is number 41. If you were to look into the details, which are widely available, you will see that there is still quite a few reforms that are needed to make sure that private sector can develop much faster and much better in this country.
And from... Ali sigurno imate neka konkretna, vi ste Ukrajinka, znate ovo područje jako dobro, ne samo da ste tu prisutni fizički, nego radite te posao izuzetno dobro i poznajete parametre u tim srednjoevropskim zemljama, a i ovim drugima, pa recimo sad mi pada na pamet. Pa čujete, pa Gruzija ima bolji rating od Hrvatske kada je riječ o biznisu. Kako to objasnite?
Yes, it's true. Georgia, which is the country of Georgia, not the state of Georgia in the US. Georgia is number 7 in doing business ranking. Why? Because they have made the decision that this was the only way. There was no other way. It's a smaller country as compared to some of the larger countries in the world. It has just below 4 million people. So in a way, it's comparable to Croatia in terms of the size. But it does not benefit from proximity to the EU, such as Croatia has. And for them, there were two ways. One way was to continue being as they were, whereby bringing investors on board was very difficult, or to start a very comprehensive reform agenda. They've done it, and that's why they have been consistently up and ranking.
Sad bi opet se vratio na ovo tko je reforme, ali ne možete to vi učiniti umjesto nas. Da, razumijem, dobro ste rekli. Jednostavno su ljudi odlučili da nema drugog puta i poduzeli su ono što se mora, makoliko bolno bilo. Je li tome, recimo, u tome prepreka konzervativnost hrvatskog društva?
I would say...
Možete vi slobodno govoriti, vidim da se smuljite tu i tamo. Vi jeste fina dama, vidim da ste obzirni prema nama, ali budite otvoreni, možda će nam vaša impresija pomoći.
Ali ja sam otvorena. Yes, so speaking about conservative, I would call it traditional rather than conservative, and I think there is a lot of positives in being traditional. You probably have managed to save the beauty of your country because you have had traditional ways of living, and this is something that really continues to be the unique proposition of Croatia. Now, speaking about whether it's possible or not for traditional society to be innovative society, I can probably think about England. So this is a country where I have lived for 20 years. So if there is a traditional society in many ways, it is so. And one of the best examples that everybody probably knows is that they drive on the left-hand side. A lot of countries everywhere in Europe, you drive on the right-hand side. English people maintain their tradition of driving on the left-hand side. By the way, this tradition goes to the ancient Rome. So it's not the English who have invented it. At the same time, if you think about England being conservative in many ways, back in 1970s, many companies and within many families, people applied some expressions which would be probably similar to what you know here, which is don't speak unless you've been spoken to. Mm-hmm. So very hierarchical. You would have to know the, your place in the society. You would have to know your place within the family, and you were not expected to speak up. But the country has changed. The country has changed in many ways. And now when you think about England, and going back to this Global Innovation Index, England is within the top 5 countries. So is it possible to be conservative, traditional, and at the same time be innovative, be competitive? Yes, it's possible. Where there is a will, there is a way.
Mene zanima, baš ću sad insistirati, koji je to naš način života s kojim ste vi bili? Rekli ste mi kad ste došli, bili ste zatečeni da smo mi ovoga uspjeli očuvati naš način života. Možete li nam detaljnije opisati?
Yes, when you live in England, you have a very good idea about life in France, life in rural France, life in rural Italy, in rural Spain, which has been described usually life as it used to be, going back to your roots, going back to where we as a society should be, knowing your neighbors, speaking to each other, knowing where your food comes from. Nobody talks about Croatia. Nobody knows about Croatia in this way. So this was actually a big surprise to me. And from this perspective, I am pleasantly surprised, and I really love the fact that here you still know where your food comes from, you still know and value your traditions, and I have traveled a lot. I have traveled not just to the coast, as probably everybody would imagine. I go fairly often to Slavonia, I love Zagorje, I love Međimurje, Varaždin. So for me, there are many faces, as you said, of Croatia. And yes, maybe there are different traditions in each of, of those regions, but people are still paying a lot of attention to preserve these traditions, and I think they should. when it comes to the cultural heritage, when it comes to the way of living within a community and within a society, this is very valuable. When it comes to business, some proactivity would be definitely welcome.
Nadam se da će ova generacija koja dolazi iza moje, jer ona pokazuje dobre znake, ove naprosto promijeniti i tu odliku naše naravi. Recite mi, kakav je odnos vaše banke spram javnog i privatnog?
So, as a bank, we aim to focus on the private sector. So, when you look at EBRD's operations in Croatia, in 25 years, we have provided 4 billion euros, of which more than 70% was to the private sector. So, for us, clearly, private sector is the backbone of the economy. The reason why we continue working with the public sector is that you do need to have a basic infrastructure and then probably more sophisticated infrastructure in order to make sure that private sector has the opportunities to develop. So from this perspective, we have invested a lot in the past in infrastructure improvements within major ports here in Croatia, motorways. Last year, we have financed Corridor 5C project. But at the same time, for us, development of private sector is really a focus because the government in itself cannot really create jobs in the long term. It's a private sector's task. And if you think about it, and it's not something that EBRD's conclusion only, but small and medium-sized companies are the backbone of any economy. Here in Croatia, you have, I think, 3/4 of the jobs that are being created by this SME sector. And in terms of their contribution to the economic output, it's also probably around 50%. So from that perspective, the question is, should institutions such as ours work with the government and private public sector, or should we work also with the private sector? Yeah. So the answer is definitely private sector. And we are very committed to provide both financing, but also advisory when needed.
To je, znači mi dali šlagvort, ovo zadnje što ste spomenuli, je vrlo interesantno. Ovo je sad emisija koja traje 50-ak minuta, ali što nakon toga? Pa da iskoristimo ovo vrijeme da možda ponukate mnoge koji to gledaju da se obrate. Koju vrst savjetodavstva mogu očekivati, koje informacije, kako ih dobiti, gdje, i naprosto koji je prosede da bi se došlo do tih savjeta, pa onda možda i do nekih aranžmana sa vašom bankom.
So when we speak about advisory services for the SMEs, we have got a team which is actually a group of people based in our office in Zagreb that work for many years now with the SME sector. We will be very happy to consider applications, further applications for advisory. There are no off-the-shelf solutions. We work with women entrepreneurs, we work with smaller companies that are looking for international advice as well as for local expertise. Sort of from this perspective, this is the product that is fairly well covered, I would say, by us as a market. But we also provide assistance to associations. And speaking about associations, I would love us to do more. And the reason why we don't do more is that it has been hard so far to find associations, sector-focused associations, that would be really willing to bring the change, that would be willing to advocate both to the policymakers as well as to the private sector how certain changes could be made in, within their respective sectors. So here we have teamed up actually with Renewable Energy Sources Association here in Croatia, with whom we have started working at the end of last year, and I expect quite significant results from this cooperation during the course of this year.
Možete li možda ne u cent ili euro, ali otprilike nam oslikati stanje Srednje Evrope, da vidimo, da se kompariramo. Koliko recimo, s koliko novca, rekli ste, otprilike, dakle, EBRD financira godišnje projekte u Hrvatskoj, ali recimo u komparaciji sa Mađarskom, Slovačkom, Češkom, kako to izgleda?
We cannot compare between the countries simply because the products that we use often are available or not in different markets. So in Croatia, last year, we have provided 150 million euros worth of funding. If you ask me, can we do more? Definitely. We could do a billion in the next couple of years if there are enough projects that we can focus on. I can tell you that there are countries, indeed, whereby we do much more than in Croatia. But there we use different instruments. We, for example, use covered bonds, which is a specific product for their banks. And this product is not available in Croatia. We're working with the policymakers here in Croatia, and this is when we speak about reforms. We do help to prepare legislation. We do help to work with various ministries. Here, in this case, it also is with the central bank in order to create some of those products so that then we can lend against those products.
Recite mi, molim vas, kad ste spominjali projekte, spomenuli ste jedan mali dodatak na moj opasku koji su to projekte. Rekli ste da nije samo važno da imate projekt, nego projekt sa impaktom. O kakvom, dakle, tu učinku, impaktu govorimo?
So I will give you a specific example in the context of EBRD strategy, for example, for the next 5 years. So we would like to focus on three strategic themes. One is green, another one inclusion, and the third one is...
Sjetit ćete se. Recite mi prvo, o prvome.
Digitalization. And the third one is digitalization of the economy. So speaking about green, here in Croatia, the topic of green is widely discussed. The question is, what has been done about it? So very specifically, the two areas where we see where we can make a difference is one, supporting the private sector and probably public sector, but for now we're focusing on private sector projects in the renewable energy in the next year or two as a minimum, because we're expecting around 2 billion euro worth of investments in the sector, which will need to be funded. And we have the know-how, we have financed renewable energy projects across all of the countries where we operate. In some cases, these were much more representative versus Croatia to date. But there is another opportunity for us to engage in what we call green cities. Mm-hmm. And Split, for example, became the first Croatian city that has joined our green cities framework. So from that perspective, there is definitely a lot of work that we can do as far as greening of the economy is concerned. Digitalization, this is a very ambitious objective. At this point in time, I'm not 100% sure how we will be financing companies with a focus on digitalization, simply because at this point in time, the scale of the project that we need to finance has to be, let's say, 10 million euro plus. So this would have to be very, very sizable companies, which we don't have as many as we would like to have in Croatia, unfortunately. And then inclusion. Inclusion of young people in the workforce, inclusion of women, inclusion in order to make sure that the operations of the companies are sustainable in terms of their relationship with the population and making sure that we are looking at various parts of the society and give them access to labor as they deserve.
Kako je to u situaciju sa COVID-om? Je li ona zaustavila brojne inicijative ili je u toj nevolji jednostavno producirala neke nove koje nisu postojale? Iako se ovo sve skupo odulji, što vi mislite, koje su tendence biznisa u ovakvom okružju?
On this, I really, truly and strongly believe that one should never miss a good crisis. So any crisis provides the opportunities to rethink, to reposition, and also to look for the areas that maybe in the past we were not focusing before, because we can see that the world around us is evolving, and it's evolving very quickly. And maybe parts of this world will be as we knew before, but parts will not. So this provides really the opportunities for various countries, as well as the private sector participants, people like us, to change, do something different, do something better, do something new. So I think clearly COVID is a challenge that none of us could have anticipated, given its global nature. But it will be interesting to see which countries, which societies, which companies will take advantage of this crisis to become stronger and to become better.
Recite mi, što je, osim naravno ovih okolnosti, u nas, u Hrvatskoj, prepreka nedostatku te inicijative, govorili smo o kulturološkim razlozima i tako dalje, ali je li moguće tu i ta naša birokracija uzela danak? Biste li vi savjetovali išta u tom pogledu?
Well, the point of doing business is very clear. If you are number 51 in the global ranking of doing business, then it means that there is work that still needs to be done in order to make sure that private sector initiatives can be developed faster than they are developed now. Notwithstanding this, to be honest, I still see a lot of examples. I see a lot of examples when companies and individuals, despite all of the obstacles, can succeed. So for me, the question is really, what is the responsibility and what is it that we as individuals, as companies, as members of a society can give to our individual environments and how we can simplify the procedures, how we can simplify the world around us in order to make it less complex. Bureaucracy exists. It exists everywhere. The question is, will bureaucracy be the overriding power in our societies? And I'm not talking about Croatia specifically, because as I said, bureaucracy exists everywhere. In England, you have bureaucracy. In France, don't even let me start on this. So in Morocco, bureaucracy exists as well. But it doesn't mean that those countries don't develop, and it doesn't mean that we need to just come up with an excuse that bureaucracy is just dragging us down. I think it's a question of working and not giving up.
Sad ste spomenuli ova tri polja koja su vam naročito interesantna, ali aktualno kad uzmemo u obzir situaciju u Hrvatskoj, u koje se sektore u ovom trenutku najviše ulaže?
For us, the sector which has the most potential, I would say probably not yet invested in, but that has the most potential clearly is renewables. So renewable from the wind, from the solar, geothermal, to recycling, making sure that you look at the products that is a waste, and then you convert this waste, whether it's in energy, heat, or actually recycle and reuse some of this project. These are really the projects whereby I see most of the potential. But in terms of the investment per se, it will be most likely wind and solar, where we will see most of the investments, as compared to other sectors.
Recite mi, spomenuli ste par puta vladu, pa onda razumijem da vaš odnos sa vladom je u Hrvatskoj u redu.
Of course. Croatia is a shareholder at EBRD, and Zdravko Maric is our governor. So from us, from this perspective, it's interesting that we are this interesting organization. On one hand, we operate as a private sector bank because we look at all of our projects very much from the commercial sense. So if the project doesn't make any commercial sense, then we will not do anything. But at the same time, we are a public sector institution with the countries where we operate being our shareholders. And we have got representatives of various countries at our board of directors. So from this perspective, I would say this cooperation cannot be closer than it is now.
A recite mi, kako ide suradnja na lokalnim razinama? Spominjali ste dobro Split u ovoj perspektivi i tako, ali govorili ste o tome da volite otići do Varaždina, da vam je poznata Hrvatska, Slovenija. Bože, Slovenija. A vidite, mi Hrvati imamo neke stare, ne rečem, Slavonija. Ovom priliku pozdravljam sa svoje prijatelje u Sloveniji. Kako, dakle, vidite tu suradnju na lokalnim razinama?
I would say these are really public sector clients that probably have the biggest potential for us on one hand, and these are the counterparties with who we have worked in the past the most. When we think about the existing cooperation, we work. We actually don't work with the city of Varaždin, not yet. We work with various cities such as Split, Šibenik, Pula. We have financed a lot of projects on the wastewater treatment facilities. I would say probably the largest part of wastewater treatment facilities in Croatia were financed by EBRD, starting from Karlovac and Sisak, interestingly enough. But also we have invested in urban infrastructure, urban transport. So the buses that, for example, citizens in Pula and in Sisak are using on a daily basis, those ones were financed by EBRD. Now, there is a new topic that we have been developing with the local municipalities, and there are three cities at this point in time that are part of it. This is urban regeneration. And the three cities are Split, Šibenik, and Pula. And these are really exciting initiatives because we are helping the cities to turn the land, the unproductive land, that has not been used for years, or sometimes decades, into a productive asset. So in the case of Split, we're talking about the site near the port. In the case of Šibenik, this is the area which is Batižela, former Batižela site, very close to the city center, but at this point in time, totally not being used. In Pula, the work is still ongoing. We also have prepared our proposal for urban regeneration here in Zagreb, particularly in the context of recent...
Samo što ću pitati, što radite u Zagrebu?
For now, not much. So we have prepared the proposal. We are hoping that this proposal will be looked at, because this is something that will definitely provide a lot of potential for the new projects that could be indeed executed by private sector, but also will create a new face of Zagreb, let me put it this way. But this proposal is yet to see the light of the day.
Recite mi na kraju, koji su vaši osobni izazovi rada u Hrvatskoj?
My personal challenges. I don't think I have challenges in Croatia.
No, što mislite onda obrnuto, da pitam, što vi osobno možete ponuditi Hrvatskoj?
That's a different question.
Zato sam rekao, ako ste rekli da nemate previše izazova, onda što imate za ponuditi?
Yes, so the reason why I really, and this is true, I'm not sort of doing it for the camera, but I really enjoy working at EBRD exactly because of this possibility to invest in changing lives. These are really the opportunities that I think could be brought to the societies whereby those changes could be possible. Knowing that I'm here for a limited period of time, so I have 2.5 years left from my assignment, I think the two focus areas for me clearly is the urban regeneration that I have just mentioned to you, and continue working with the association with regard to the renewable energy, as well as private sector, to make sure that renewable energy sector develops much faster than without our support. So these are the two areas where personally I'm definitely committed, and when I think it's really worthwhile putting efforts. In addition to this, I also realized that in order to bring about the change, we need to do something as individuals. So from that perspective, I have been mentoring a number of companies here. And when you talked about the fact that it's a traditional society, things don't work, I'm actually mentoring a cooperative brewery led by two women from Zadar, who are producing Plavuša and Neposlušna beer. How conservative is a society where you have got these two successful young ladies? So this is something that I do on a voluntary basis, let's put it this way. I'm also starting to give lectures at the local universities because I think it's important to make sure that the young people, the young people are those that are here to actually implement all of those innovative ideas. Mm-hmm. Young people are those that need to learn from positive examples. And this is really what I can do in addition to making sure that from professional perspective, I can contribute to a change here in Croatia, but also I can leave behind people who can say that there was something or there was somebody who invested in changing their lives.
Hvala vam lijepo na tome. Hvala lijepo na vašem gostovanju u ovoj emisiji. Hvala na vašem vremenu. Dragi gledatelji, hvala vama što ste bili sa nama još jednom i gledajte nas sljedeći puta. Do tada, doviđenja i lijep pozdrav.